Hello and welcome, my friends. My name is Elon Osborne, and this is my YouTube channel where I talk about movies, audio, and music. And if you're into that too and want to see more videos like this being made, there are plenty of ways to help support this channel.
Like this video, subscribe, become a patron, rock some merch, get some tunes, read my children's book to you kids.
Link in description. Link in description.
Boy! As of February 26, 2021, the SVS Prime Satellite 5.1 system now ships with the SB1000 Pro subwoofer. But since I have a large open concept living room, I went for the ported PB1000 Pro. The entire system is available in premium black ash, piano gloss white, and piano gloss black. The Prime Satellites are little loudspeakers that pack a punch. Measuring 8.85 inches high, 4.9 inches wide, and 6.3 inches deep. The front grille is removable, revealing a 4.5 inch mid-range woofer that is mounted in its own dedicated and completely sealed compartment that produces clear mid-range and bass output that is free from coloration. Above that is the 1-inch rigid aluminum dome tweeter providing airy, natural, and smooth high frequencies. For their size, the frequency response dips down to an impressive 69 Hz and goes all the way up to 25 kHz, with a sensitivity rating of 85 decibels at 1 meter. If you're going to place these on speaker stands or another surface, they do come with these nifty 3mm elastomer stick-on bumper feet. Or, if you choose to mount it to a wall, it has a keyway bracket or your standard 1/4 inch by 20 threaded insert, which was conveniently what I already had waiting on my walls. The SB1000 Pro subwoofer is a beast, sporting an all-new front-firing 12-inch driver powered by a Sledge STA325D amplifier with 325 watts RMS and 800 watts peak power. It measures at a compact 13.5 inches high, 13 inches wide, and 14.76 inches deep. So basically, a cube. For a more detailed look at the subwoofer I'm reviewing with this system, the larger ported PB1000 Pro, you can find a link in the description below.
How do they sound?
Up until reviewing this 5.1 system from SVS, my main satellites in my home theater system were from the Klipsch Reference Theater Pack.
I'm filming here. Can you, go away? Oh, rude. All right, moving on.
Quick comparison.
The Klipsch satellites have 3.5 inch woofers compared to the SVS's 4.5 inch woofers. The Klipsch's mid-range frequency response cuts off at 110 Hz compared to 69 Hz with the SVS's. The Klipsch satellite sensitivity is rated at 91 decibels at 1 meter compared to SVS's 85 decibels. The cabinet on the Klipsch speakers is plastic, whereas the SVS Premium Black Ash satellites have a sleek wooden look to them which feels very sturdy and rigid with some sort of hard composite material. So in regards to the frequency response in particular, one thing I was very excited about with this particular system is that I could finally set my crossover frequency to the recommended THX 80 Hz. So I went into my Onkyo receiver's settings and set my front and surround speakers to 80 Hz. Instead of being set to 120 Hz like they were before, gaining that extra 40 Hz in the mid-range and gaining an inch on the woofer size does make a difference. I wasn't blown away because these are still relatively small speakers, and it takes a lot of energy to push audio over that fairly long distance between these speakers and me on the couch. But there was one thing that I noticed immediately when I went to one of my go-to test scenes, the tunnel shootout in John Wick 2. Bullets whizzing by and ricochets were much more pronounced. A couple of them even really startled me because I hadn't heard them with such detail and clarity before. These SVS satellites are known for their natural, neutral, airy tones, so dialogue wasn't as sharp or crisp as the Klipsch satellite speakers, but that's not necessarily a bad thing. It's just a more accurate representation of how it should sound, as opposed to the Klipsch satellite speakers that add just a touch of coloration to the high frequencies.
Note.
Just as a footnote, when I originally filmed this, this was about 3 weeks ago, honestly, and since then, I really think the high frequencies are coming out more clearly. So it's just like any good speaker, they're going to have a break-in period before they really start to show their true colors. So these little satellites seem to be aging like a fine wine.
Even though the SVS satellites have a lower sensitivity rating of 85 decibels compared to the Klipsch's 91, I honestly didn't find myself needing to turn up the volume any more than I normally would, which was honestly a pleasant surprise. And that subwoofer? Come on. I find it ridiculous that the PB and SB1000 Pro series are in tier 1 of SVS's line of subwoofers. The 12-inch driver, the rigid, tough-as-nails cabinet, the deep subsonic frequencies that it's capable of reproducing. When working in tandem with the Prime satellites, it's the best wide, discrete, wired 5.1 sound system that you can get around $1,000. Don't get me wrong, the Klipsch Reference Theater Pack is still by far the best bang for your buck budget option for a complete 5.1 sound system, especially because it can be found at $299 certain times of the year. But if you're wanting to go just beyond a budget 5.1 sound system without having to spend several thousand dollars, the SVS Prime 5.1 satellite system is well worth the price tag. Because you're not only getting great speakers and a killer subwoofer, but you're also getting the unrivaled quality customer service of SVS. I'm sure there are plenty of you watching out there that know exactly what I'm talking about. I've had such an easy and pleasant experience with the SVS staff. In comparison, I've reached out several times to Klipsch, not just blatantly asking them to send me products to review, but just asking what their qualifications are for YouTube product reviews. Guess how many responses I've gotten?
Three. Two and a half. Oh, no way.
So with SVS, it's not just the price of the product that you're paying for, but also a customer service experience that goes above and beyond what any home theater company should provide. So keep that in mind next time you're thinking about upgrading your home theater system. So, basically a cube.
Cool.
So, basically a cube.
All right. Now?
So, basically, when I went to watch one of my go-to test...
Try again.
Ooh. The deep subsonic frequencies that it's capable of producing.
Whoops. Don't do that.
Let me know in the comments below what your SVS...
Try again.
So there you have it, folks.
Let me know in the comments below what your SVS customer service experience was like. I hope you enjoyed my review of this truly amazing 5.1 system from SVS. Be sure to like and subscribe so you don't miss out on another video like this one. And of course, always be listening.
Robot.